everybody. What's up? I'm Emily Paris, and welcome back to my channel. So, for those of you who don't follow me on social media, my Instagram, the rollincolon, I post a lot on there asking you guys for what you want to see. And this is hands down the most highly requested video that I have ever gotten. How do I dress with an ostomy? It's something that a lot of people face because for however long of your life that you went without having an ostomy, for me it was 22 years I didn't dress with an ostomy bag. I didn't know how. I didn't know how to hide it. I didn't know how to feel confident dressing. I was always worried about people looking at my bag and clothing. And one thing I will say is that people aren't looking at your bag as much as you think they're looking at your bag. Also, a lot of people actually thought it was like an insulin pump for diabetics, which I think is kind of funny. But anyways, so today I'm going to be showing you a bunch of different outfits, sharing my tips and tricks on how to dress with an ostomy. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Also, head over to my Instagram so you can be included in the polls and, you know, kind of send me your video request and maybe I will do a video that you want to see. Okay, that made no sense, but all right. Okay, so one of my biggest tips and tricks for dressing with an ostomy, especially for females, is to wear your bag on the outside of your pants. One thing that made me very frustrated when I would look at other women wearing an ostomy bag and clothing is they would say, you can wear tight clothing, and they'd have on these really skin-tight, painted-on leggings, a tight top, and you could barely see the outside lining of their bag. The thing that I'm thinking is, no duh, we can't see your bag, it's empty. What are you supposed to do when it starts to fill up? And one thing that a lot of women come across, especially women that are a little bit thinner, is it makes it so that you look like you have a penis. And I, for reference, am 5'2", so I'm very short, and I weigh like 110 pounds, so I'm super petite. I wear a size 0 jeans. And so it wasn't easy for me to hide an ostomy bag in my pants. So one of my biggest tips is to wear it on the outside of your pants, and I found that that really works for me. Now, Emily, I don't want to have a ostomy bag. The tan color isn't very pretty for Hollister. The gray isn't ideal for Coloplast, and maybe my insurance only covers see-through bags. So my tip is to wear an ostomy cover. This one just so happens to be Mickey Mouse. I also have two black ones and a white one. Obviously I don't use anymore. For those of you who are new here, I don't have an ostomy, by the way. Duh. I'm just doing this video to help other people. So, back to what I was saying. I really liked these because they covered my bag. Like, this one was nice for when I was at home because it covered my bag, so I didn't really have to look at the actual bag. But then the black one actually blended into my denim really nicely. I wear a lot of black and black denim, and so it just kind of blended in. And like I said, a lot of people just thought it was an insulin pump. I also went to a graduation last May and wore white pants, and which was very risky for me, I will say. I wore white pants and I wore a white ostomy cover, and you could barely see it. I'll insert some photos here of me wearing ostomy covers with clothing, and you can barely tell that I'm even wearing it. The other thing that I will say before I start showing outfits is, if you are going to a special occasion where you want to wear something smaller, or you don't want your bag to be as noticeable, you can go to your like ostomy supplier and request for them to send you smaller bags. Just say I want to try them and use those smaller bags. You're gonna have to empty them a little bit more, but I think for like a wedding or something it would be really nice to have. So let's get into some of my tips and tricks with an ostomy. So I can't remember if I mentioned this in the intro, but just in case I didn't, those ostomy covers that I'll be showing in this video, this is not sponsored, I wish it was. You can find those at the Undercover Ostomy on Etsy. I'll have their link down below. Highly, highly recommend them. I've washed them a tons of times. Never afraid. I really like them. They're easy to use. Big tip. High key. Get yourself some. So, one of the questions I get a lot is, how the heck do I wear jeans? My favorite jeans to wear with my ostomy were the American Eagle Super Stretch Skinny Jeans. I like these jeans, one, because they're comfortable, they're super stretchy. I wear a size 0 or a size 2, just kind of depends. These are the mid-rise jeans. Low-rise would probably work even better depending on where your wafer sits. I don't recommend high-rise jeans just because you end up smushing this bag, which can get stool up in here where your wafer and your stomach is, which can cause leaking. I don't recommend that. So I like this because the pants sit right below that wafer line. Now, the question that I get a lot is, I don't like that tight jean bumping up against the edge of my wafer. My solution is, one, check out Target maternity jeans. They kind of are like jeans on the bottom, yoga pants on top. My problem was, because I'm small, I couldn't find jeans that fit me small enough. Like, everyone that was pregnant to wear maternity jeans was bigger, and they didn't make any small enough for me. The other thing I would recommend, which I actually just thought of as I was planning out this video, is what you could do is, if it was just a little bit too tight, just like a half an inch too tight underneath that wafer, would be to just cut maybe a slit down in your jeans. That way it kind of opens that up and gives them a little bit more stretch. The other thing is, if you have a lot of room that's bumping up there, is what you could do is maybe take this section of your jeans, like so from your belt loop to your button, cut that out and then sew in a piece of elastic, so it kind of gives a little bit more give around that bottom of the wafer. That would be my tip. I totally think you can wear jeans with an ostomy. I don't think you have to take that out as an option. The other question that I get a lot is, how do I wear tight clothing? So the other question that I get a lot is, how do I wear tight clothing? Can I still wear tight clothing with an ostomy? And I actually think ostomies look better in tight clothing. I think when you wear baggy clothes, just in general, not just with an ostomy, it makes you look bigger than you are. The other thing is, I don't know if you can tell, but when you wear looser clothes, it kind of gives you this tabletop effect on top of your ostomy. Like, your shirt just wants to sit there, and you'll see it in some of the other shirts that I'm going to show you, is that it kind of just wants to sit right on top of your bag. So I think that tighter shirts kind of pull that in and kind of slim it down and make it a little bit easier than like some of these poofier like sweatshirts. Winter is great for having on ostomy because you're wearing coats and all that stuff. You could also wear a scarf that maybe goes down this way that kind of hides the bag. Or I used to like to tie plaid shirts around my waist because it kind of camouflaged this whole area. So I'm going to change my outfit and show you guys another little tip I have. Okay, I'm back and I'm in another outfit. So this is a little bit slouchier of a shirt. And now, just because I said that ostomies look better in tighter clothing doesn't mean you can't wear your favorite slouchy off-the-shoulder tops. This is one of my favorite shirts. The way that I like to do this is, I'll actually tuck a little bit of it in next to the ostomy, so it kind of pulls that tight against there and gives you like a little cute little tucked in detail. Like I said, you don't have to give up your favorite clothes. You don't have to go buy an entirely new wardrobe with an ostomy. It's not necessarily, and it's highly expensive. But hey, if you want to use it as an excuse to get some new clothes, I know I did. Highly recommend. So this is one of my favorite outfits to wear. These jeans are black distressed denim from Target. They have really good jeans, just regular. These are their mid-rise jeans, and these actually sit like the American Eagle jeans right underneath that wafer snap cap. And so this is perfect. The black jeans are great because that black cover blends in really nicely, and you're not kind of exposing a naked bag. Also, I forgot to mention, but the bottoms of these bags have like little, I don't know if, ooh, this bag is filled with water and I don't have a stoma, and so water just got on my skin and really scared me. Oh my goodness. So the bottoms of these bags have little fold out things, so if you have to drain your bag, you can do that. You don't have to take off the bag every single time. So oh my god, that cold water really scared me. So this outfit is really nice. It does still kind of give you that shelf look, which I'm not a huge fan of, but it's not the end of the world. And it just kind of looks like you're wearing like a baggier, looser shirt. Now, you might be asking, Emily, I work in a corporate setting. I have to wear dress pants. How do I do that? Guess what? I've got the answer for you. I actually have these. I wear them and I don't have an ostomy anymore. These are the Lauren Conrad work jeans. Let me adjust the camera. These are the Lauren Conrad work jeans. They are very dusty right now, but they have, they're elastic, but they look like work jeans. They are skinny style, so if you're not a fan of that, then you might not like these. Now, Emily, I have to tuck in my shirt. My boss says I can't have our shirt untucked. Once again, don't worry, homegirl, I got you. What you're gonna do is tuck in your shirt like normal. When I had my ostomy, I worked in a restaurant. We had to tuck our shirts in. I bent the rules and I didn't tuck in my shirt, but if your boss doesn't let you break the rules, then that's fine. So you're gonna tuck in the shirt. Emily, I got this stupid looking thing. Don't worry, girl, don't worry. You're gonna tuck around the ostomy bag and kind of pull it up so it meets this line. Like I said, you're gonna have this like tabletop effect, but it's fine. It doesn't look that bad. If you want, you can wear those bubble skirts that kind of hit here and then bubble out. But I think that this looks fine. I don't even think you can really tell that I have an ostomy, and the people in your workplace probably know that you have an ostomy. So yeah, this is my work outfit. And my last look is just some classic leggings with a t-shirt. Like I said, this does protect it a little bit more, and you can always wear like a really tight tank top underneath these shirts. I'm just wearing some leggings. These leggings are from 90 Degrees, I think is the brand. They're just really cute. And then just a basic t-shirt from Target. This is actually one of the first t-shirts that I bought post-colectomy because it was an extra small and it was the only thing that fit. So, once again, I just kind of do the little side tuck. You can see it doesn't look bad. It looks fine. And you can't even see the bag. And I mean, you can if you turn sideways, but it's not really that noticeable. I've never had somebody really be like, what is that? I had one person say that to me. It wasn't that weird. So guys, I hope that you enjoyed this video. I hope it was a little bit helpful for you. If you have specific outfits that you want to see or like a little bit more dressed up, how about dressing up with an ostomy? That could be a cool video too. I wanted to go ahead and shoot this video before I'm leaving on a trip. That's why I'm filming it in my mom's room. So if you want me to do a little bit higher produced video, I can do that for you guys too. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Go check out all my social media. I'll leave a link for it down below. Yeah, I don't know why I'm out of breath. Oh my goodness. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.